Mdina is a staple on the Maltese Islands, and in this video, we will show you just that on this marvelous walking tour of the city. Our tour will begin from the outside of Mdina, and we will then walk into the city through its main gate. Next, we will walk along the streets and show you a still of people walking through Bastion Square. For these first few minutes of the video, I will briefly introduce you to Mdina and tell you a little bit about it. Greetings from Mdina, the silent city of Malta. Welcome to the ancient city. You'll soon discover why this ancient city was named Silent City as you walk with me through its narrow streets. The cobblestone streets of Mdina are more than just a destination. They evoke centuries of history with every step you take on them. The purpose of this video is for you to have an insider's view of the city, as well as letting us introduce you to Mdina, its past, its treasures, and why it should be on everyone's list. Let me begin by giving you a brief history of Mdina. Mdina, Malta's ancient capital, has a rich history dating back to 700 BC, when it was first fortified by the Phoenicians and known as Maleth, meaning the protected city. Over the centuries, the city was shaped by various rulers, including the Romans, who built a governor's palace, and the Arabs, who further fortified it. The layout of Mdina reflects the Fatimid period beginning in 870 AD, while the oldest surviving structures date back to the Norman period, during which the city's defenses were strengthened with thicker walls and a wider moat. The city also bears traces of the Byzantine and Arab influences on its architecture and fortifications. Mdina served as Malta's capital until Valletta was built by the Knights of St. John in the late 16th century. Mdina's fortifications include three gates: the main gate, built under Grand Master Vilhena when he enlarged the Vilhena Palace in 1724, featuring statues of St. Agatha, St. Paul, and St. Publius; the Greek's Gate, the oldest of the three, which led to St. Nicholas Square and was used by a small Greek community and slaves; and the third gate, Garrikin, constructed by the British, connecting to a 19th century train station. A significant earthquake in 1693 caused damage to Mdina's cathedral, prompting its reconstruction in Baroque style. Despite centuries of history and a steady flow of tourists, Mdina retains a peaceful, almost timeless atmosphere that distinguishes it from other Maltese towns. Despite its small size, Mdina offers a wealth of experiences. One of the must-see sites is St. Paul's Cathedral, a spectacular Baroque masterpiece that sits proudly in the heart of the city. A cathedral built in the late 17th century is believed to have been constructed on the exact spot where the Roman governor Publius met St. Paul after his shipwreck on the island of Malta. Mdina Dungeons is a chilling reminder of the city's darker history. Beneath the Vilhena Palace are underground passageways that lead to chambers and cells, once where prisoners were imprisoned. Here, you will be able to gain a better understanding of the medieval justice system and the harsh conditions in which prisoners were kept. There is an entrance to the dungeons that is located right next to the main gate of Mdina. As you walk through the dungeons, you will see various methods and instruments that were used to torture the prisoners during the medieval era, demonstrating the brutality of the Maltese prisons. These scenes were recreated, depicting how harsh the prisons were. The Vilhena Palace, originally the Magisterial Palace of Justice, was significantly expanded by Grand Master Antonio Manuel de Vilhena during his tenure, 1722 to 1736, as part of a broader plan to rebuild Mdina after the devastating 1693 earthquake. This Baroque palace, designed in the style of the Knights of St. John, required shifting the main entrance gate, a change still visible today from the city's fortifications. The Vilhena Palace is now home to the National Museum of Natural History since 1973, houses extensive collections in geology and paleontology. Visitors can explore exhibits featuring Maltese birds, fish, mammals, as well as over 10,000 rock and mineral samples. The museum also showcases thousands of exotic shells, insects, and an impressive fossil collection, along with detailed displays about Maltese insects, birds, and marine fauna. This fascinating museum is incorporated within the historic Vilhena Palace, adding another layer of significance to the building. Deeper inside Mdina is the Knights of Malta attraction. This offers an engaging journey through the history of the Knights of St. John, who played a pivotal role in Malta's past. Located within the city's fortifications, the exhibit features several life-size tableaux and a 3D audiovisual show that narrates the history of the Knights, from their arrival in Malta to their departure in 1798. Another highlight is the Palazzo Falson, one of Medina's oldest buildings. This historic house museum offers a glimpse into the life of a Maltese noble family with its impressive collection of art, antiques, and curiosities. Don't miss the rooftop terrace, where you can enjoy panoramic views over the Maltese countryside. If you have a sweet tooth, then make sure to stop by the Fontanella Tea Garden, which promises delicious cakes and a fantastic view of Medina. This is a beautiful place to relax and soak up the atmosphere of the city. Aside from these, there are a few other sights to see within the walls of Medina. Take a look at the links in the description to learn more about what to see in Medina and what to do in the city. So, why visit Medina? Beyond its rich history, Medina offers a sense of serenity that's hard to find elsewhere. The city is largely car-free, which adds to its tranquil atmosphere. Walking through its streets, you can't help but feel like you've stepped into a different era. The quiet, the architecture, the sense of peace, Medina is a place where time stands still. Medina is also a photographer's paradise. The play of light and shadow on the golden limestone walls, the intricate doorways, the panoramic views from the bastions, every corner offers a new perspective, a new story to capture. Many visitors wonder how long they should spend in Medina. While you could easily see the main sights in a few hours, I recommend dedicating at least half a day to fully immerse yourself in the city's ambiance. Take your time exploring the hidden corners, enjoying a leisurely meal, and simply soaking in the atmosphere. As for whether it's worth visiting, yes, absolutely. Medina is a gem that captures the essence of Malta's history and culture. Whether you're a history buff, a photography enthusiast, or simply someone who appreciates beautiful, tranquil places, Medina has something for you. Getting to Medina is pretty straightforward. If you're staying in Valletta or Sliema, the easiest way is by bus. Malta's public transport system is efficient, and several routes will take you directly to Medina. The journey from Valletta takes about 30 minutes. If you're driving, there's parking available just outside the city walls. Once you arrive, you'll enter Medina through the imposing Medina Gate, a grand entrance that sets the tone for the experience to come. And from there, the city is yours to explore, step by step, at your own pace. As we continue to stroll through the quiet streets of Medina, I hope you've been able to feel the magic of this unique city. Medina isn't just a place you visit, it's a place you experience. From its ancient history to its serene atmosphere, Medina leaves an impression that lasts long after you've left. Now sit back and continue exploring the city of Medina with me. If you enjoyed this walk, don't forget to like the video and subscribe for more explorations. Vai lá, ok?
Sao kiếm anh vô?
Hello, we got a tour by the horse and carriage.
Yes, what you want to remedy in the garage, huh?
Take a tour with the horse and carriage. Hello,
like
to ride by the horse and carriage. I'm going to go to
Ci ho messo all'ombra.
Ah, su, cosa ne
I saw a guy using a freaking leaf that has a spanner.
Thank you. Thank you. tanta bulla, adesso sei riuscito a salire.
No te lo que quiere que haga. pelo perto del pelo. Ya, creo que será la madre.
Ragazzi, attenzione, quasi scivola, ok? Tenetevi nella
cioè, almeno mezza giornata.
Este museo ristorante vaza, mas aí não tem ninguém aqui que mora.
Museum,
Thank you for sticking with us until this point. We hope you have enjoyed every minute of it. Would you like to watch another walking tour of Malta? Click on the pop-up box that just appeared on screen to watch our walking tour of Valletta, Malta's capital.